My registry scan reported hundreds of errors. Which ones do I fix? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. I ran a registry cleaner on my machine and it reported over 700 errors. How do I know which ones are safe to clean? So my opinion on registry cleaners should be pretty clear by now. I really don't think that they're useful at all. And in fact, one of the reasons I don't think they're useful and occasionally even harmful is exactly what you're seeing. They're reporting lots and lots of errors that, in all honesty, aren't errors at all and can cause people to take more drastic measures than they really need to. Let's run a registry cleaner, have a look at what it's reporting, and then I'll share my approach on what to do about it. So I've got CCleaner free running here in my Windows 10 home machine. I'll go ahead and click on registry and we'll go ahead and scan for issues. And as you can see, it's reporting issues, lots of them, all sorts of issues. It's finding them in various places for all of the different kinds of things that it has listed in the left-hand pane of the CCleaner window. Now I can scroll through all of these. You can see it found 131 errors here, 131 issues, let's be clear. So if we run through these, you can see that there's a variety of things, and how do we know what to do with any of them? They run the gamut of random kinds of issues or things that CCleaner and other registry cleaners will identify as issues. Most often, these are things like files that no longer exist, orphaned registry settings resulting from uninstalling or updating software, and just other general things that, yeah, technically they shouldn't be in the registry. Technically, they don't need to be in the registry, but technically, there's no harm in leaving them there. And that actually takes you to my preferred approach. My preferred approach, of course, is not to have run this registry cleaner at all. There's no point. My second recommendation, if you do run a registry cleaner, you can't resist the lure of running a registry cleaner, do nothing with the results. You'll find that your machine will run just fine. The other approach, the other end of the spectrum, and what I'm going to do right now, is if you're going to run a registry cleaner and you're going to accept its results, don't try and figure out which of the hundreds of errors it's going to present you with, you should deal with. Deal with all of them. If you're not going to deal with none of them, deal with all of them. Here's what that looks like in CCleaner. I'm going to review the selected issues now that it's done its scan. Do I want to back up the registry? I'll talk about backing up here in just a second. I'm not going to do a separate step here. Here, you could indeed go through each registry issue one by one, all 131 of them in my case, and make a decision on whether or not to fix it or move on to the next one. My recommendation, again, if you're going to go this far, fix all the selected registry issues and then close. Then we're going to scan for issues again. There's still a few issues. As it turns out, cleaning some of the issues can expose new issues. So we're going to do that. We're going to run the registry cleaner again. We're going to review the selected issue. We're not going to back it up this time. And we're going to fix all of the issues. Close it, scan for issues yet again. This particular issue, this ActiveX COM issue, I've tried to clean it before. I'll review it. I won't do a backup. I'll fix the issue. We'll close it. It's no longer listed. I'm going to scan for issues yet again. That same issue is probably going to pop up again. And sure enough, there it is. Aside from that, though, I've cleaned up everything that it offered me. And I'm going to go ahead now and close CCleaner. My registry has been cleaned. So what? My position remains that in general, scanning your registry using a registry cleaner is probably riskier than the possible improvement that might result from having run it. It's extremely rare these days for registry cleaning to have any noticeable impact. So I strongly recommend that you not. If you do, ignore what it tells you, and if you can't, clean them all. There is one incredibly important prerequisite to all of this. Before you do any of this, before you fix any registry errors, back up. Take an image backup of your machine so that in case cleaning the registry causes more problems than it solves, you'll have a safety net. It has happened. It can happen, particularly with some of the lesser known, less reputable registry cleaners. But my recommendation, don't do it. But if you must, back up first. Hopefully that helps. Hopefully that helps clarify what you need to do in situations like this. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/2893. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.